Hello and welcome to this Lansweeper 5.2 tutorial. Lansweeper 5.2 is the next major update of our network management software and will officially be released in the very near future. A beta is available on our website at lansweeper.com/forum, so feel free to update now and follow along with this tutorial. 5.2's most important new feature is mass deployment. It allows you to manage the Windows computers in your network and install and uninstall software, make command line changes, kill processes, and run custom scripts. This tutorial is meant to give you just a taste of what you can do. We'll be creating a deployment package to silently install Adobe Reader on multiple machines without user intervention, creating a dynamic asset group to deploy the package on, deploying our package and reviewing the changes that occur. Let's get started. Okay, so I've prepared this deployment by researching silent install procedures for Adobe Reader. I've downloaded a Reader 11 executable from the Adobe website and found the parameters I need to perform a silent install with this executable. Different programs require different installation procedures, so it's best to research these procedures online. What I've also done is added my executable to the Program Files Lansweeper Package Share folder on my Lansweeper server. This folder is automatically created and shared when you install Lansweeper 5.2 and can be used to store your deployment executables and scripts. To keep things organized, I've placed my executable in an Adobe Reader folder, which I manually created, under Package Share Installers. With the executable in place, create your package in the Deployment Packages section of the web console. Hit the New Package button and submit a name and description. For this particular deployment, tick Rescan Assets as well. This will automatically rescan your computers when the deployment has completed, so you'll see up-to-date information on your computer web pages. We won't touch the other settings for now, just hit OK to start configuring your deployment. A package consists of one or more steps, with each step leading to either another step or a success or failure message. Our deployment will consist of two steps. The first step is a file condition that checks whether our Adobe executable is present in Lansweeper's Package Share folder. You can easily reference this folder with the Package Share parameter. If the check is successful and the file exists, the package should proceed with the next step, which will be the Adobe Reader installation. If the file does not exist, the deployment should end in a failure message. Basically, if someone accidentally deletes our executable, our package will give us a warning. This step looks okay, so let's create the next one. The second and final step is an installer step. We're going to launch our executable with the parameters we've previously researched. The successful completion of the step should end the deployment in a success message. A failure should end in a failure message. Our package is ready. Now we'll create a dynamic asset group to deploy the package on. Dynamic asset groups are new in Lansweeper 5.2 and let you group assets based on criteria. This allows you to quickly and easily target your deployments to specific machines. Create a group by hitting the Add Dynamic Group button under Configuration Asset Groups. The first filter we want to add is one for installed software. We, of course, only want to deploy Adobe Reader on computers that don't yet have the software installed. And just to make things more interesting, let's also specify that only 64-bit computers within the Lansweeper domain should be included. Hit the View Assets button to see a list of computers that meet your criteria, and then hit Deploy Package on the left. Select your package and hit OK to start deploying. Again, we won't bother with the other settings for now. Under Deployment Logs, you can see the progress of your deployment. Our package is initializing, so let's wait a few minutes for it to complete. Okay, I've refreshed the page and most installations have successfully completed. One machine generated an error, but is likely offline. You'll notice that we can't ping this computer either. If we click through to a machine whose installation did complete, we can now see Adobe Reader listed in the Computer Software tab. The History tab also indicates that the software was added. In addition, you'll notice that the machine is no longer part of the dynamic asset group we created earlier, as it now has Adobe Reader installed. That's all there is to it. Of course, you can customize your packages further and deploy based on a schedule or as your machines come online, but that's beyond the scope of this video. Thank you for watching, and keep an eye out for more tutorials.